Hello, in this video I will be talking about wheat. Why today's wheat may be one of the most harmful ingredients in your diet, how eating wheat speeds up the aging process, how modern wheat protein is elevating the rates of celiac disease and wrecking your digestive health, how wheat creates acidic conditions in your body destroying your bone health. Low fat diet today promote whole grain ingredients including wheat, which is the world's most popular grain. But what was once a relatively benign ingredient has become rather dangerous as a result of recent changes to its protein structure, from making us fat, weakening our bones, and producing deadly compounds that damage our organs. Modern day wheat is taking a toll that far outweighs the pleasures of even the tastiest cookie. In past centuries, it was enviable status symbol to have a big belly, for it meant that you led a life of leisure and had plenty of money for food. Nowadays, however, it's not just the privileged ones who have expensive waistlines, it is people from all walks of life. And rather than envy, those people are often subjected to pity or ridicule with derisive terms like beer belly. Although this is a popular term for a protruding gut, a more accurate name would be wheat belly. Since the 1980s, there have been ongoing public health campaigns against fatty cholesterol-packed food such as butter and bacon, since these kind of foods are believed to contribute to heart diseases. But as a result, many people have replaced those foods with the ones that are rich in carbohydrates. And out of all the available carbohydrates, one ingredient that has risen to the top is wheat. It is not a coincidence that as our diet has grown to become more wheat-based, our waistlines have also expanded. Of course, eating wheat is not something new food trend. It's been a staple in the cuisine of many cultures for thousands of years. In the Bible, Jesus is described as having performed a miracle by feeding 5,000 people with just 5 loaves of bread. And when Moses was leading his people to promised land, he promised them that wheat would be one of the most bountiful crops there. But the problem is that wheat that grew thousands of years or even just a few generations ago was vastly different from the crop we know today. The big difference is in the protein structure. In the later half of the 20th century, scientists created a type of wheat which was designed to be more resistant to environmental threats like drought and fungi. The result was a hybrid crop that contains a different protein structure than before, and it has become the primary type of wheat eaten around the world today. To be precise, modern wheat hybrids contain 95% of the same protein found in the original crops, while the remaining 5% is made up of new and unique protein. What is especially disconcerting is that the government and food regulation agencies around the world have shown little interest in whether or not these new proteins are safe for human consumption. Therefore, we are essentially eating massive quantities of new and untested food. The ancient evolutionary predecessor of the wheat we eat today is called Anikorn wheat and is also found to have little or no side effects and not so much spike in sugar as compared to the dwarf wheat that we consume today. If you were to compare random photographs of Americans from the earlier 20th century to the ones from today, you had probably noticed a lot of differences, including clothing and hairstyle. But it's also hard not to notice the difference in the size. The average person today is much larger than the people they were back then. Over the past 5 decades, the number of obese people in America has nearly tripled, and one of the biggest reasons is that today's wheat has a unique harmful effect on the blood sugar and insulin levels. Studies show that the carbohydrate in wheat, known as amylopectin A, increases the blood sugar levels more than just about every other type of carbohydrate, including those found in ice cream, candy bars, and even processed white sugar. When amylopectin A is digested, a lot of insulin gets released in our body, which causes our blood sugar levels to get lowered. However, the way insulin works is causing our body cells to open up, absorbs the excess sugar, and converts it into fat. In other words, when you eat wheat, your body is receiving an excess of sugar that is turning into fat as quickly as it can. What's interesting is that we can determine wheat's fattening effect by looking at a unique group of people who avoid ingredient altogether, that is, those with celiac disease. People diagnosed with celiac disease must follow a strict wheat-free diet, and many are diagnosed as adults after having already spent years consuming wheat. According to a 2004 study at the University of Iowa, obese adults who had recently been diagnosed with celiac disease lost an average of 27.5 pounds in the first 6 months of a wheat-free diet. That's right, they just lost the weight simply by ditching wheat. You may be familiar with the addictiveness of drugs and alcohol, but less attention is given to the similar effect of what's in the bread box and a cookie jar. Wheat is addictive, and its impact on the human mind is both profound and frightening. People who follow a wheat-free diet experience better moods, fewer mood swings, improved concentration, and better quality of sleep. Astonishingly, For some people, these benefits will kick in a matter of days after their last bite of bagel or pasta. However, there are those who give up wheat and face a long and difficult period of withdrawal symptoms, which can include fatigue, irritability, brain fog, and even temporary depression. We can begin to understand just how large an impact wheat has on human brain by observing its effect on people with schizophrenia. Philadelphia Hospital in 1960s confirmed a link between wheat consumption and schizophrenia. Essentially, after removing all the wheat from the patient's diet, it was found that there was significant reduction in the symptoms such as hallucinations and delusions. According to the latest research, there is a substance in the wheat called exorphins that has been linked to the ability to move from bloodstream into the brain. In doing so, they can attach themselves to the very same area of the brain to which opiates such as heroin bind themselves. With the exception of some cheese and fine wines, most things generally deteriorate with age, including the human body. And yet, some people tend to age gracefully and others not so much. The reason some people are able to maintain a youthful glow and others are not is all about AGE, age. In this case, age stands for Advanced Glycation End Products, which is the name given to all worthless biological debris that accumulates in the body over the years, especially in the organs like liver, kidney and skin. As the age builds up, they form clumps which reduce the ability of our organs to function properly. It's thus believed that age are responsible for many late life ailments such as clogged arteries, cataracts and dementia. For example, when age clump in the brain, they cause brain cells to stop functioning, and in the kidneys they can cause the organs to become less effective at filtering the waste products from our blood. Fortunately for us, there are ways to avoid dangerous buildup of age, and as you may have guessed, one such way is to eliminate wheat from your diet. In fact, if creating age were a competition, wheat would beat nearly every other carbohydrate including sweet potatoes, apples and chocolate bars. Modern wheat protein is elevating the rate of celiac disease and wrecking your digestive health. For over a million years, humans, as well as our pre-human ancestors, lived a hunter-gatherer lifestyle that was completely devoid of wheat. Instead, it was based on wild game, plants, nuts and berries. The farming of wheat began only around 10,000 years ago, which is pretty recent, relatively speaking. And given that this has led to such a big dietary change, it stands to reason that many modern humans have digestive systems that are unable to stomach this development. This failure to adapt has resulted in celiac disease, which is the inability to tolerate gluten, a major protein in the wheat. Unfortunately, given the changes in the modern wheat, this is disease on the rise. In the last 5 decades, the case of celiac disease have increased by 400%, and the last 2 decades alone, rates have doubled. Research suggests that the reason behind this dramatic spike can be tracked back to the changed protein structure found in the modern hybrid strains of wheat. In 2010, study by Dutch researchers, 36 varieties of modern wheat were compared to 50 wheat varieties that were popular around 100 years ago. The researchers found that modern varieties had a higher level of gluten protein that are responsible for triggering celiac disease. In particular, modern wheat contains a gluten protein called gliadin, which shows up in far smaller quantities in ancient varieties of wheat. What's especially troubling is that gliadin is consumed, our intestines releases guanulin, which in turn increases the permeability of the intestine. As a result, lining of our intestines gets disrupted and gaps begin to appear. Now those gaps will allow wheat proteins like gliadin to escape the intestine and enter our bloodstream. When this happens, your autoimmune system will respond by increasing the levels of inflammation as a way of fighting what is perceived to be as dangerous intruders. Crucially, this inflammation is the hallmark of celiac disease, and in severe cases, it can lead to ailments as chronic fatigue, arthritis, and even gastrointestinal cancer. Wheat creates acidic conditions in your body, playing havoc with your bone health. Human body has a variety of regulation systems in place intended to keep you healthy. One of those regulatory systems is the amount of acid in the body. It basically works to keep your body at a normal pH level of 7.4, because when that level is off by even the smallest amount, it quickly deteriorates. Now, you may not think of wheat as being acidic food, but unlike other plant-based foods, wheat generates significant level of acid in the body. Studies show wheat to be a rich source of sulfuric acid in particular, and when conditions in your body become too acidic, that internal regulatory systems take radical action. One of the key defenses in your body's alkaline stores, which are salts that can naturally balance and acid levels. So when those levels goes up, those stores is tapped into. However, this store is also home to calcium phosphate and calcium carbonate found in your bones, and these two ingredients your bones depend on in order to stay strong and healthy. Nevertheless, your body's pH balance is so important that it supersedes bone health. This means that more alkaline your body requires in order to neutralize acid, the more brittle and vulnerable to fractures your bones will become. With this in mind, a sensible diet would be one that doesn't threaten your health and your bones. And yet, by eating a diet rich in wheat, that is just what we are doing. In 2003, a study by University of Toronto researchers looked into the effects of bread-based gluten on the body's calcium stores. They found that increasing gluten consumption resulted in increased calcium loss from bones, and as a result, bones experienced the kind of weakening that eventually resulted in debilitating bone disease called osteoporosis. The final summary is, it's time to eliminate wheat from your diet. Wheat wreaks havoc with several aspects of your health and well-being, including your digestive health, your ability to maintain an optimal body weight, and your body's delicately balanced pH levels. Modern wheat is both addictive and unpredictably different from wheat of centuries past, and is causing rates of celiac disease to rise as well as contributing to the deterioration of our bones. These all things are based on the book named Wheat Belly by Dr. William Davis and Grain Brain by Dr. David Perlmutter, in case anyone is interested in reading about all these things. Best of luck.